Okay?
I'm fine. Mr. Zakaria was just leaving.
What the hell do you think you're doing here?
Relax, kid. You're gonna give yourself a migraine.
You tried to frame Abby and it didn't work. I am not gonna let you hurt her again, so you need to leave. Now.
I just did your girlfriend here a pretty big favor. Ask her. I lined up a sweet new gig for Abby, working for a very high-powered attorney. Maybe you've heard of Angela Dwyer.
The lawyer who got Brandon released after he almost raped Abby?
Just because a lawyer defends someone doesn't mean they necessarily endorse that person's crime. This is the U.S. of A, kid. Even dirtbags like Brandon are guaranteed the right to legal counsel.
Okay, listen, no. You have given me several things to consider, but right now I'd like you to leave.
No problem. Excuse me, young man. Don't let him talk you out of this. It's a big opportunity for you.
I'll keep that in mind.
Oh, by the way, it really brightened my day to be able to get all those nasty charges against you dropped. It was like a life-affirming thing to support young love.
Abby, I'm sorry you had to deal with that guy again. And of all the sick ways he tries to work you with Brandon's lawyer?
Maybe that's what it takes.
What do you mean?
Well, he's ruthless. A killer, a liar. Maybe that's what it takes to succeed in the mob. Are you still sure that's what you want to do with your life?
Look, Abby, even if I become the most powerful mobster in the world, I will never be anything like Anthony. He's a nut job.
Well, I'll keep my fingers crossed. And what?
Isn't this the part where you warn me I'll be throwing away my future and wasting all my potential?
You already know how I feel. I don't have anything to add. But I have had some time to think about it, and I was wrong to give you the ultimatum like I did.
You were? Yeah. Yeah, you were.
Look, I don't want to be one more person who's trying to control you.
I said that, didn't I?
Yeah, you did, but you were right. You know, from the very beginning when we first met, that's what's made us so special. We don't judge each other. And I broke that rule. I'm sorry.
So, what are you trying to say?
I'm saying that even though I don't agree with you wanting to join the mob, I'm not going to judge you. I accept you for who you are. Plus, I missed you so much that I could never send you away like that again. No more ultimatums. I just want to be with you, no matter what you decide to do with your life. Okay, and now that that's out of the way, I think we should get back to celebrating our new understanding of each other. So. What's this? What is this?
My college acceptance letter, the one I never actually applied for. You can throw it out.
Not on your life. Babe, come on, you should really consider whether or not you want to go to PCU in the fall.
Well, first I want to find out who's the one who sent in the application behind my back.
Okay.
Even though I'm pretty sure I have a good idea.
Hey!
Hey.
Oh, it's so good to see you.
I'm so happy to get your message. Your father and I were just talking about you. I'm so excited and so proud of your graduation.
Yeah, when you talked to Dad about my graduation, did you happen to mention to him that I got accepted into PCU?
What are you talking about?
Mom, I'm not stupid. I know you're the one who's responsible for this.
You got into PCU! This is is amazing! You think I did this?
Very convincing, Mom.
I swear to you, I had nothing to do with this.
You're like someone else would fill out a college application for me, really, Mom?
Michael, I didn't set this up. But I think it's fantastic you got into PCU. I mean, something like this falls into your lap? And it's PCU, it's close to home.
Who said I'm going? Look, Mom, I have no idea how you pulled this off behind my back, and I'm sorry to disappoint you. But, Mom, I have to make my own decisions for my life.